Recording, can everyone hear me?
Hey everyone, I hope your day is going super well, and more importantly, I hope y'all been taking good care of yourself. We are still living in a COVID society, so online school is pretty common for amongst you all. I'm sure what I've learned over the last month or so about that video I posted, seeing y'all's problems with online school. And the thing is, online school is very detrimental to mental health. And I've always said that the school system has a lot of flaws, let alone they're making it online school, which takes down more salt into the wound. I'm just gonna cut to the chase here, coming to think about it. And this is what I had to say on a different camera.
So this is my quick thesis to you all, is that your parents don't know you the best. They don't know what is best for you. They only know what's best in their reality. And the thing is, life is already so short. So why do you have to live based off what others want you to live? Lately, I've been posting a lot more political posts. A few videos was about the presidential debate. And my mom was like to me, "Well, Kentron, you've been getting very political the last few days." Bro, there's so many other people that post political stuff and no one complains about them. So why can't I post my stuff? How come I can't post how I feel? There's a lot of people feel like that I'm voicing up for them. And this is what my purpose is in this world, is to voice up for the voiceless. So I told my mom, like, "Mom, I'm sorry. If people don't like my post, they don't have to watch me anymore. They don't have to follow what I do. They don't have to know what I do. They don't have to see what I do. I do me. They do them." You know, like, I've seen posts that I don't like, but guess what? I don't cry about it. I still go up and say, "Hey, I put my head up high and just keep on going forward. From here on out, that's how I'm gonna execute it, because that's who I am. Life is way too short. I post what I wanna post, you know? And this is how I feel, and this is what I feel. And this is what I'm gonna do, and this is how I'm gonna predict it. If I give up, I'm gonna regret it. So that's why you have to push how you feel, even if you don't like it. What's worse, pain of pressure or pain of regret?"
And all I have to say is that if your heart touches others and it's truly from you that makes you happy from the start, then nothing else should matter. That's how I see things, you know? And there's a lot of things that I don't understand about this world. And the way this world formats, it's designed to make you a robot. And as soon as I'm woke, I feel a lot more free doing other things, you know? Like my YouTube channel, I feel so much more free doing this. One of the best sayings that I love: "I would much rather live 10 years as a lion than 40 years as a sheep." I'm not a sheep, I was never a sheep. I don't follow the matrix. I'm a wolf, I hunt for my grind. I hustle, I hunt, I grind. I hunt for my success, I make it myself. I'd rather be a lonely wolf than to be in a group full of sheeps, you know? I'm a wolf. I'm gonna take on a lion so I can be the lion, so I can be the king, you know? That's what I'm designed for. But this life matrix, it's very comfortable if you're a sheep, but as soon as you wanna be a wolf, then to king, then it gets hard all of a sudden. And then some other people are be like, "Kentron, I don't think you should say that. That makes others feel uncomfortable." Bro, does a wolf and a lion compromise their character for the happiness of a sheep? No, 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 no. And the thing is, even if I do compromise, do you think they'll actually want to fight for my crown? No, only I can fight for my crown. Only I can polish it, and only I can be the only guy wearing it. Even my supporters that are cheering for me to get it, at the end of the day, I still choose whether or not I go for it. So I'm gonna go and fight for that crown. The Matrix makes me look like I'm the bad guy. I'm like, heck no, heck no. No one understands until you win. And I had a friend who told me, "Kentron, I'm not too sure if my parents will support me in my TikTok life." Well, the thing is, they don't understand why you're doing this now. The Matrix will never format a life that you want to live. Seriously, because if you think about it, you have to go to school, right? Or otherwise your parents will get in trouble. School itself, you're pressured because you're competing with other students in a false illusion of thinking, "Oh, if I get the best grades, I'm all of a sudden this." No, it's only a competition who can be the best sheep out there. And it's very toxic, it's very toxic. I was never good at school, and I was so stupid for believing that. We should all think for ourselves, and not blindly follow like a sheep. I don't get it, but going back to my friend's point though, until he becomes successful, which he will be because I believe in him, and he believes in himself, the day when he gets his crown, he's gonna use all his success to pay back his parents that raised him to be where he is. Right now, in their minds, is that you get good grades in high school, go to a nice college, then you get a nice job, and then you can, you know, be happy for yourself. But the thing is, that's what they think. That's what my friend's parents think. But that's not really the case. He doesn't wanna, I'm sure he doesn't wanna work a 9-to-5 job for the rest of his life? His parents aren't gonna see that until the day he wins. So I'm telling you all right now, all of the chosen ones, all the woke hustlers out there, no one's gonna get your success until you win. Too many people are depending on something tangible. The Matrix makes you depend on something tangible for you to understand. Us as woke spiritual hustlers, we don't depend on things tangible. We're an art. We make art. We don't care if people don't see what we're seeing. We want to make ourselves happy so then we can help others that truly support us. That's what we want to do. And going off of a side note, how come no one ever mentions your grind from 7 p.m. to 2 a.m.? You know, because everyone talks about 9-to-5, 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 but no one ever talks about 7 p.m. to 2 a.m. And school never teaches time management. This is another thing I don't like about school, is that school never teaches about time management. School never does inspire you to be a hustler. They teach you how to be a follower, not a hustler. God dang it, you know? I'm not saying we should all be rich, but we should all be hustlers. And I felt like I did waste a lot of my time. And the thing is, after you graduate school, right? Now, you go to college. College will teach you how to be a very, very good sheep, and then you can get a good job that will keep you miserable for the rest of your life, and then you have your 9-to-5, but no one ever will talk about your side hustle from 7 p.m. to 2 a.m. And when do you really start having fun? Oh, when you're 65. But by then, when you're 65, do you have the energy to live freely? No, I'm not gonna wait till I'm 65 to have fun. I'm gonna start now. I'm gonna start now. Because the thing is, from 19 to 20, your body changes. Your body changes. And the energy won't be as consistent as I am now. Because as soon as I'm in my 20s, I probably may not run as fast, I probably may not lift as much, I probably may not be as fast as I am or energetic, and I value energy. Energy is what I value. What makes me amazing is that I can stand out compared to a lot of people in their 20s because I have a sharp mind, you know? And most people in their 20s, they consume alcohol. I don't consume any alcohol. And that's why I can get a lot more done compared to my other friends that are in their 20s. And that's what makes me proud as a woke hustler. I've not gone to any college parties so far in my life. Never. And I'm proud of it. You know why? Because I value me. I value my energy. I value my hustle. I value my grind. I value my future most of all. Parties are to keep you distracted while you're in college because they want to keep that balance in you. Because the thing is, think about it, how they talk about parties, they normalize you getting drunk, but they never ever give you an inspiration to be someone big because they want to keep you in that institution. I don't do that. I don't want to go to any college parties, you know? I value a sharp mind. That's why I'm charming. That's why I'm super charming. I can charm a person faster than a light bulb. I can energize the crowd faster than fire. But right now, as a person who hasn't hit his 20s yet, I am doing my best to energize other people and get other people woke so they don't have to live a life that others want them to live. They can live a life that they want to live. Live a life that you want to live. I don't want to live a life that other people tell me. That's just weird. And do you think they'll really save me if my ass starts to get in trouble? No. But if I go take the risk, I know how to save myself. But if you depend on another person, no fucking way they'll save you. But most of the time they won't. That's why you gotta be willing to be brave enough to be by yourself. And only the woke people can understand me. All you bots that wanna laugh at me because I'm talking all this crazy stuff that in your world are crazy, I don't care. Now for my brothers and sisters who are working 9-to-5 jobs because you guys probably don't have a choice in life and you're probably from a walk of life that you still have to pay bills or whatever, remember your 7 p.m. to 2 a.m. rule. You can still do that. You can still do that, all right? Trust me on this one. I know it's hard right now, but for those who do have time for yourselves, that are fortunate, that don't have to work a 9-to-5 at this point of their lives, go take advantage of it. Take advantage of it now. I'm taking advantage of it right now. I'm doing my best. I'm doing my best to save money smart and invest wisely and grind so hard that I can be a motherfucking king. I want you all to do the same as well. And yes, I am happy that I'm never invited to parties. You know why? So I have more time to focus on myself. So I have more time to focus on my dreams. There's a lot of reasons why, where I am right now, I can do a lot of things that other people my age can't do. I'm woke. I'm charming. I'm a hustler. I want you all to do the same thing. You have to protect your energy, make sure that you spend your energy wisely, and you fight for yourselves. Because you don't have to follow what the other sheep are doing. You don't have to do that. You can be you. You can be the wolf. Sure, it feels weird that the wolf is near the sheep's farm. But if you're brave enough to escape into the woods where other wolves are, where it starts to get competitive, at least you're happier and that sheep energy isn't into you anymore. And you can fight for yourself. All I'm trying to say is that life is way, 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 way too short. And let alone, you want to spend a good portion of that short time on a format telling you how to live? I don't think so. Not with me. I break the rules. I think woke people break the Matrix's rules just so they can make themselves powerful. Because we're not just humans. We're multi-dimensional beings. Stay woke. Stay beautiful. Keep meditating. Let's go.